Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. It is Francesco here, and in today's feature I'll be passing over to Yvonne, who will be diving into ClickUp and touring around how she uses the project manager ClickUp to get things done during the day. Now, Yvonne runs a fantastic YouTube channel called Ask UV, which is spelled A-S-K-Y-V-I, and I'll include it in the link in the description. She dives into ClickUp, Airtable, hundreds of tutorials there if you're looking to go a lot deeper. Now, this is quite exciting because she's going to be touring us around her application, which I believe is the 2.0 version, which is their latest release. So I'm going to be passing over to Yvonne. Thank you, Yvonne, and please do introduce yourself and tour us around your ClickUp account.
Hey everybody, I'm Yvonne Hyman with AskEV.com and I am a business efficiency consultant. Now, what does that even mean? That means I help digital entrepreneurs streamline their business, build workflows, and just clean up their processes. No matter if that means getting through some of the mindset crap that just happens for entrepreneurs, or if it is implementing technology to make your life easier and stop that everyday rat race and the feeling of being a hamster in a wheel and running all day and not getting anything done. Over on my Ask EV channel, we are all about efficiency. Running you efficiently, yes, a body needs workout to run efficient. Running your business efficiently, running your team efficiently, and using technology efficiently. And today I am here to show you how we use ClickUp and their new 2.0 release to run our businesses and work with our clients more efficiently. Now let's go look. So let's dive right in why I love ClickUp so much. For me, ClickUp is like Asana and Trello had a baby on steroids. All the features people love about those two tools, and then just take it to the next level. That's what ClickUp is to me. But it doesn't matter if you don't know how to use it for you. We need to be able to use a tool or it's just worthless. So let's see how we use ClickUp internally. The board you see right here is a client workflow, meaning that's pretty much our CRM right there. How we do that is we have set up custom statuses. The open ones are people that we have talked to that weren't quite yet ready yet that we need to follow up with in the future. Potential clients are right now potential clients that we are in conversation with. Follow up, we have sent out a proposal. It's all in the works. We need to follow up with them. Proposal stage, self-explanatory. Working on clients. We are waiting on something to hear from the client back. We need to finalize the job. Maintenance for web design, for example, monthly maintenance clients. Closed is clients that have been offboarded, clients that decided to go somewhere else or whatever might have happened and they are not a client at this point anymore. And it's a simple CRM. You can use dates with it if you need to remind yourself to follow up with something. So you just jump right in there and set the due date to the date you need to follow up with them. You can leave your notifications, comments, any kind of thing. And that's our internal CRM. How for others, you might not like this kind of look. There we have our regular list look. This is kind of what you are used to seeing in Asana a lot. We also have the calendar view, which then shows you all the things that need to be done. But in 2.0, it becomes even more interesting. So if we look at a client right here, this is how we used to handle blog or general editorial calendar before. We used to collect all of the ideas of blog posts that we were going to do, ideas collecting right here. The ones we decided to do go in here when we are working on them, when we need to finalize them, and when everything is done. That's how we used to do things. Now we've moved it around with the new views that are here, and we use an embed of Airtable to collect our ideas and then move them into the to-do list rather than collecting all of the information right here. And the fun thing is, you even can take that to the next level. You can have your regular board view with all of the tasks and all of the due dates and all of that stuff. Now, if you're doing social media, we collect all of the social media posts throughout the months in an Airtable base that is embedded right in here. With the editorial, in this case, this is specific information where we are collecting the blog posts for additional share on Pinterest and more information. When we do listicles, they are all collected in here when they are there. This is a fresh one. With guest bloggers, all these kind of things are collected right in here. You don't have to go over to Airtable anymore. It's completely embedded right in here. Now, for businesses, something like this is really great. You can add right here a document, which is a regular empty document, and you can collect all kinds of information. Now, that allows you to build a full-on SOP in here. SOP standing for Standard Operating Procedures. Now, with that, it eliminates, potentially for your business, the need of another tool like Notion, for example. What you can do is you can go into the exact space, add a view to that, do the document right there, and make this document your SOP, which doesn't allow me to, come on, work with me. There we go. It allows you to add a document specifically to a full space, to a client folder, or to a task list. If you can't find them, all of them are going to be housed right in here. Now, what does that mean for you? That means you can make ClickUp your interactive standard operating procedure. You don't have one handbook that as soon as it's printed out, it's outdated and it doesn't work for you anymore. No matter if you want to have an SOP specific for the client and you just add it to that folder and you add the document right here, or you embed an Airtable with additional information, or you embed any kind of Google documents. Because if you go here, you also can embed spreadsheets or Word documents from Google, anything like that. Now, you do that as a space for your company's SOP. You do that on a client folder as the client's SOPs, or you do that on a list as the job-specific, the service-specific SOPs. And it can stay there. Nobody has to leave ClickUp. It is so seamlessly integrated that you eliminate, I don't even know how many clicks and therefore how much time you save your team or yourself every single day in here. And if you can see, we have tested a lot over the last couple of weeks since we were able to get into the beta program of 2.0. I am really excited. There is more page views coming down here. And as a final and last little tip for you when you're working with the team, that box view right here, ooh, that one is fun. You don't see much right here right now because I am in this folder and that is my own folder. Not much is happening in there, but let's go up to the space. And now let's do the box view right in here and look what it does. We have unassigned tasks right here. We have Carl right there, Casey right there, and me right there. Now I see exactly how many tasks are not done, how many are done, the percentage with that, what kind of status are they in, and I even can open up and see what needs to be done. And I can go in here and all of my unassigned ones, and I can assign those tasks. Nothing gets lost anymore. Everything is right there, and you can track what's happening in here. So If you think ClickUp is great for you, go jump on it. You can totally start for free. There is a forever free plan. Go try it. It is an amazing tool. I know moving from another tool is daunting. We do have a lot of videos on that. There is a lot you can find on ClickUp on YouTube. And their customer support is amazing. So you are not alone in this. And at any given time, if you get stuck somewhere, reach out. I am always here for you. Just look for Ask Evie on YouTube. Send me over a DM, message me. I'm always here to help. And let me know in the comments. Jump on in. What kind of productivity tool are you using right now? What are you using for project management? Have you used ClickUp? And what do you think about it? How do you like it? Jump in the comment section. If you like the video, go give it a thumbs up. Francesco is doing an amazing job on this channel, so go follow him, go subscribe, and make sure to hit the bell so you get notified when he uploads a new video. I'll see you soon.